So how was your holidays? I hope that you have enjoyed your holidays, right? And yes, how are you all? You are all fine and safe, right? Yes. So do you remember anything in social now? Yes. In last year, we have learned 5 lessons in social, right? So do you remember what are the things we have learned in those 5 lessons? So in the first lesson, we have learned about the latitudes and longitudes, right? So in that we have seen the definition of latitudes and longitudes and some of the important lines of latitudes and longitudes, right? Yes. And in the second lesson we have learned about the different temperature zones we have in the world, right? Yes. So in this lesson we have learned about the factors affecting the climate and also we have seen based on the latitudinal lines how the temperature zones are classified. So do you remember what are the 3 different temperature zones we have? The torrid zone, the temperate zone and the frigid zone, right? So we have seen this in our second lesson. And what we have learned in our third lesson? So in the third lesson, we have learned in detail about the torrid zone. So in this, we have learned about the equatorial rainforest and also about the tropical deserts, right? So we have seen how will be the climate, how will be the plant life, how will be the animal life and how will be the life of the people in this equatorial rainforest and the tropical desert, right? And then the fourth lesson is about the temperate zone and the frigid zone. So in this fourth lesson, we have learned about the life of the people, the climate, the plant life and the animal life in the frigid zone and the temperate zone, right? Yes, at last we have started to learn about our country, right? So in the last fifth lesson, we have seen how election is conducted in India, right? So we have seen what are the role of the Election Commission of India and the political parties in this elections, right? So do you remember all those things? Yes, I hope so. Okay. So this is our first class in this new year 2021, right? So in this class, we are going to start our new lesson, that is the Indian government. Okay. So in the previous lesson, we have seen how elections are conducted and how the government is selected, right? So in today's lesson, we are going to see what are the roles of this government. Okay. So we are going to learn about the Indian government. So first, do you know what is government? So for example, let us take our class teacher. Okay. You are having a class and you are having a class teacher, right? So assume this class teacher as a government. Okay. So for what purpose you are having a class teacher? So you are having this class teacher for taking care of you, right? So she is there to take care of you only. So she will make some rules for your class and if you are breaking the rules, she will give you some punishments and she will appoint some members in your class itself like class manager, table arrangement leader, smart board leader, right? So she is doing all these things for the welfare of you only, right? In the same way, we are having government. Okay, so government is there for taking care of us, right? So government is something formed by the people for taking care of the people. Okay, so they will make some laws and they will make us to follow that laws. And if we are breaking those laws, they will punish us. Okay, so one of the best examples we can say lockdown, right? So lockdown is one of the rule passed by our government. So now it is little bit free, but just think about the beginning days. So we should not go outside of our home, right? So if we go, we will get nice beats from policemen, right? So for what purpose they have given that rule? To protect ourselves from coronavirus, right? So for our goodness only, they are making rules and they are making us to follow that rules, and if we are breaking that, they will punish us. Okay, so understood for what purpose we are having government. So government is something that is ruling us, so that is elected by the people to take care of the people. Okay, so in this lesson we are going to learn about our Indian government. Okay, ready? Shall we start? Yes, children. Now, before entering into the lesson, first let us see what are the things we are going to learn in this lesson and what is the basic idea for learning this lesson. Okay. So, first see what are the things we are going to learn about what are the role of Indian government. Okay. Role means what? their main duties. Okay, so what are the main duties of our Indian government? And also about the role of judiciary. So what do you mean by the term judiciary? Judiciary means something related to law, right? So what is that? Court. Okay, so we have court, judges and lawyers, right? So we are going to see what are the role of this judiciary. Okay, so role means duties. Okay, what are the important duty of this judiciary? Okay, so what are the two main things we are going to learn in this lesson? So at the end of this lesson, you should be clear about the role of the Indian government and also about the role of judiciary. Okay, and why we are learning this? We should know that the Indian government performs various functions in different level. Okay, we have our Indian government and it is providing various functions to us in different levels. Okay, it is working in different levels. That is the main idea behind this lesson. Okay, to understand that only we are learning this lesson. Okay, so same way why we are learning this lesson? To understand that the Indian government performs various functions in different levels. Okay, and what are the things we are going to learn in this lesson? About the role of Indian government and also about the role of judiciary. Okay, so in today's class we are going to have only a short description on this lesson. Okay, so today we are going to see just what is the government and what are the different levels of government. Here we have seen, right, government is performing at different levels. So we are going to see what are the different levels. Okay, so from the next class we can see the duties of this government. Okay, so in today's class we are going to see what is government and what are the different levels of government. Shall we start? So in the beginning of the class itself I said to you what is government, right? So government is something that is formed by the people to take care of the people, right? So this government will make laws for the people and ensures that everyone is following that laws. Okay, so by formulating various laws they are helping people to live safely. Okay, so for example we can say a small law about wearing helmet, right? So if you are going out without wearing helmet in a motorbike, then you are fined, right? So you don't have permission to ride a boat motorcycle, right? People who are 18 years of age and above only can ride a motorcycle, right? And also they should wear helmet when they are riding that, right? So if they are not wearing helmet, then they have to pay a fine to the government. So that is one of the simple law. Okay, so government can make laws for the people and ensures that they are following the rules, and if they are not following the rules they will punish us. Okay, so government is something to help with the betterment of the people. Okay, so in the last lesson we have seen how the government is selected, right? So we will select our government with the help of elections, right? So people will vote for their favorite persons. And at last, the political party which wins in maximum number of constituencies will form the government, right? That's what we have learnt in our previous lesson. So we are electing our government by our votes only, right? So who is ruling our India now? Which political party? That is Bharatiya Janata Party, right? So Bharatiya Janata Party is ruling our country right now. And which political party is ruling our state, Tamil Nadu? So Tamil Nadu is ruled by ADMK, right? So thus our government is formed. Okay, so now we are going to see what are the different levels of government. Okay, so see, our India is a very big country, right? So ruling this as a single level is very difficult. So in our school itself we can see, so if there are more than 25 students in the class itself, means we are dividing the class, right? Because handling that much children in a class is very difficult. And if less number of students is there in the class, then we can manage them very easily, right? So we are dividing the class into section A and section B. But all of them belongs to 5th grade only, but divided into 2, right? In the same way, our India is also very big, right? So managing it as a single level is very difficult, okay? So they are dividing it into 3 levels, okay? So what are the 3 levels? See, central, state and local government, okay? So it is divided into 3 levels, central, state and local. I think we have learnt about this in the 4th grade itself, okay? Central government means our entire country as a whole, okay? Whole India. And state means our state Tamil Nadu. And local means we are having our levels of our government. Okay, so Sami, what are the three levels of government we have? Central government, state government and local government. Okay, and the functions of the government in each level will vary. Okay, so their roles and duties will differ in different levels. Okay, that's what we are going to learn in this lesson. Okay, so we are going to see the function of this central, state and local governments in our coming classes. Okay, so that's all for our today's class. So in today's class we have seen only what is the government or what are the different levels of government, and most mainly we have to know what are the different levels of government. So what are the different levels of government? Central government, state government and local government. Okay, so that's all for our today's class, children. So as this is the first class in this year, I have given only a very short description on our new lesson, right? So we have just introduced our new lesson. Okay, so we are going to learn in detail about this lesson in our coming classes only. Okay, so if you have any doubts in today's class, contact me. Okay, so from the next class we can see what are the different roles of this government. Okay, meet you in the next class.